sick, The Atlantic magazine calls John Wayne a hollow masculine icon, millions furious. Was John Wayne a wimp and was his favorite director John Ford gay? According to The Atlantic magazine, they were. They claim that John Wayne was an overcompensating pawn. They are very lucky that the Duke is dead, because I suspect he would have paid them a visit they wouldn't have liked. Wayne was once asked what real men were made of, and Wayne replied, "I am what men are made of." By all accounts, he was. He would have made quick work of the pansies at The Atlantic. Ford's wife Mary might have something to say about his manhood after being married to the director for 53 years. Reviewing Nancy Schulenberger's book, Wayne and Ford, The Films, The Friendship, and The Forging of an American Hero in this month's issue of the Once Great magazine, Stephen Metcalf soliloquizes on the two icons of early American cinema, director John Ford and his protege, the Duke himself. Ford was a manic, closeted homosexual, Metcalf implies. Wayne, a hollow shell of a propaganda stunt, a bumbling buffoon used naively to propel the myth of American masculinity on the big screen. The actor's persona was inextricable from the toxic culture of Cold War machismo, Metcalf writes. I have to wonder if Metcalf is the modern Gore Vidal who was so ashamed of being effeminate that he tried to prove that all of America's greatest men were gay, including Abraham Lincoln. The only evidence Vidal was able to offer was that Lincoln often slept in the same cot with generals he was visiting. The truth is, because in those days it was impossible to visit some areas and get back the same day, many times generals shared their cots with their fellow generals, and Lincoln did, too. Metcalf offers no proof against either man except his personal opinion, which is about as worthless as teats on a boar hog. People who actually knew Wayne said he was an imposing figure who was the same in real life as he was in his films. But they also said he was friendly and kind to all those he met until he was angered anyway. John Ford made 140 movies in his 50-year career, including 23 with John Wayne. They include such movies as Stagecoach, The Searchers and The Man Who Shot Liberty Valance. Wayne's movie persona was a tough-as-nails fighter who always doffed his hat to ladies and who possessed compassion even for those he didn't like. And he taught us valuable lessons in his movies. In The Sands of Iwo Jima, taught us that courage is being scared to death yet you still saddle up. In True Grit, he taught us that even lost causes are an impediment to someone willing to take a chance and do the right thing. In The Man Who Shot Liberty Valance, he taught us to defend those who can't defend themselves yet he didn't take the credit for those acts. Our advice to Metcalf is to keep picking on dead people, because a real-life John Wayne would flatten his pretentious ass. As Wayne would have said and did in fact, life is tough. It's tougher when you're stupid.